Ladies, it's absolutely fantastic to have you here with us at the Entertainment Media Show. Have you been enjoying it so far?
Yes, so much. This is our first time in the UK, so
we love it.
Yeah,
love London, love Heathrow. It's been really amazing.
And it's been very organized. Everybody here, the entire crew, the organizers, it's been actually quite a pleasure to work with everybody because, you know, we've been to a few conventions and some people are just, I guess they're not as experienced, and it takes a lot of people and a lot of organization to run the show, and this show is run real well.
It's immaculate, we love it. Yeah,
we love it. We're having a lot of fun.
And we love the Radisson.
And we love your British accents.
I like the sound of all of that. Now, what have you been thinking of the British fans then? What have they been like? Have they been treating you nicely?
Yes, they've been amazing.
You know, I don't want to diss anybody, but to be honest, like, different countries are just
interesting. We're going to leave it at that.
No. What I'm saying is, like, to come to a different country instead of just in America, like, the fans and the people in general, just culturally, it seems a lot warmer. It's very warm in here. Like, people are so nice and
very
sweet.
Very nice, yeah.
It's so
and
awesome.
Gorgeous. You all here have great jeans. Blue eyes, light skin, light hair.
See, we like the other side of the fence. We're from Venezuela, blah, blah, blah. Anyway.
What's the most common questions you've been getting today?
How is it working with Quentin Tarantino and Robert Rodriguez?
And Danny Trejo. That's usually
Trejo, yeah.
That's usually the first question we get.
Do you guys like working together?
Yeah, we get that all the time.
Sure. Are you guys twins?
Yeah, we get that.
Really?
Yeah. Are you guys even related?
We get that.
Those are the questions we get.
I'm not going to ask you if you're related, but I guess I should ask you, you mentioned some of the fantastic people you work with, you know, Quentin, Danny. We feel like we know them because they're such big characters, they're such big parts of our lives, but I mean, what are they really like on set?
Oh my God, amazing. Danny Trejo is the sweetest, most humble person I've ever met.
He really is. Yeah. He will do any work, even if it isn't paid. If somebody calls him...
No, that's not true.
Well, okay.
He has a very tough agent.
Before you start sending him scripts, he might want a little money.
Tough, awesome agent, but...
Yeah, amazing agent that makes sure that he doesn't say yes to everything.
But he will say yes to everything.
Yeah, he will say yes. He loves to work, and he's very humble, and he accepts everything in life. He's extremely grateful to be alive, to be well, to be working, to be healthy. And
he doesn't really get grumpy. Before he gets grumpy... He will tell you that he is not feeling well or he's tired. You know, he won't get grumpy or he won't act like a diva. Yeah. And Robert and Quentin are just creative geniuses in different ways. I feel like Quentin is a genius writer.
Storyteller.
And Robert is too. Robert is too, but Robert is more a genius cinematographer. And Quentin is as well. But it just like, I feel like they separate themselves in that sense.
What makes it so attractive is its raw quality. It's the fact that
grungy.
You can shoot it yourself and make it look, and it can be really shitty, and it still can be cool if you know how to tell a story and if you have great actors. You know, so it's. I think it's just it just opened the possibilities for anybody to make a movie, and
I think the internet generation just all of a sudden being more open to. Exploiting sex and violence.
Yeah.
And anybody can do it with a camera at home, and all of a sudden people are more accepting.
Please, though, if you are going to video sex at home, keep the violence out of it. No violence, just that's...
Right?
Yeah.
I agree with you. 100%.
Violence is not necessary.
You know, to be honest, I have a huge problem with American movies. And oh my God, I feel like men get a kick out of... exploding violence, and men get what they want in violence out of movies, so much so that it's accepted, like, in every TV show, in every movie that is done in America, and love scenes are cut after a second, and it's like, you're promoting so much violence, and yet, like, love stories and love scenes and love sex in movies is such a taboo. It's like, I'm sorry, I was born naked. The reason we're here is because everybody's having sex. Why can't we see it? This is a problem.
When I saw Michelle Rodriguez, you know, coming to the screen and just kick ass and be, like, at the same time nurturing and fucking awesome, you know. And same with Jessica Alba. I mean, it's always Osama, you know. I think Robert really knows how to you know, show his women extremely powerful and nurturing. And Quentin, yeah.
I think they're feminists at heart in some way. I'm not a feminist in, like, the separating, girls from boys or, like, women from men, but more than anything, just empowering women.
Yeah, there's something very exciting about seeing a woman that is empowered, I think, you know? I think men are attracted to powerful women, you know? And
intimidated by it, too.
Yeah, but that's what's exciting. There's nothing more exciting than being afraid of something. You know, you gotta be afraid to be excited. Otherwise, it's fucking boring. You know?
Skew the cursing to the minimum.
Effing boring.
He is just a scary-looking Mexican man with a big heart.
Who doesn't say a word, and you don't know what he's thinking about.
And, you know, he doesn't... You know, the fact that he says machete don't text, like, he seems illiterate, but then, he has a revolution behind him. So it's, like, it's really funny. And he's clever, and he's a badass.
Yeah.
This guy is 68.
Yeah.
Danny Trejo is 68 years old.
He's such a badass.
He can still kick ass. Like, he is incredible. And people can relate to that. People can relate to the man who maybe had a very unfortunate life, and he was kind of, like, behind, and then he was just like, no, this is my life. I'm taking over. You know, we all feel like the last fruit in the basket sometimes, and we all want to get picked first, and you know, he makes his life go on, and that's
it's
exciting.
It's very inspiring. I think Danny Trejo, his presence, everything that he's done is very inspiring, and I think that's why we get so excited to see him.
Is it especially nice to see a hero from Danny's background? Because we don't often see that. We often get the kind of Captain America-style hero, but it's nice to have, a Mexican gun-toting hero for a change.
Mexican Latino. I think
with the scars and the... Yeah, you know...
Is he the first Latino, like, hero? Like that?
No, I think there's been others.
Cool.
I'm trying to remember.
Not really, like,
not as mainstream, I guess.
I guess what you can say about Danny is he's the first person who's really transitioned from being typecast as a background supporting bad guy because of his looks to suddenly being embraced as, no, you can be a leading man. Audiences, they don't want to just see you for 5 minutes and have that be your favorite 5 minutes. They want to see you for the whole film.
Exactly. Yeah, I agree. I think that he's definitely the first... To be put in that situation, in that position, and
in such a mainstream
of his
way.
Of his race, in such a of his age, his race, and be, you know, so highly accepted worldwide, for sure.
It's so exciting. I celebrate him.
He's so awesome.
One of the most wonderful human beings I've ever met. He really is.
I love you, Danny. We love you.
Machete set the bar pretty high for action, violence, and how do you think Machete Kills compares to Machete?
I think it's probably times 1,000.
Yeah. The plot is really, really, really intrinsic and a lot of storylines, and it's very deep, and it touches a lot of social issues, and you know Robert, he's intense, you know, he's a rebel. So he's bringing up really interesting issues, and he's doing it with the most kick-ass cast.
And he's comedic too, and that's what he gets away with some pretty harsh issues.
Yeah.
So I think Machete Kills is going to kick some butt compared to Machete.
Yeah, I think so. I think it's going to be...
As it should.
The sequels, I mean, if you're going to do a sequel, it better be better than the first one.
More often than not, we're disappointed by sequels. I don't think we will be disappointed.
No, I think this one's
going
to be
better
amazing.
Than the first.
You mentioned, obviously, Robert tooling himself up with another great cast. Can you talk a little bit about some of the new faces we're going to see?
Yes, we're excited to see Charlie Sheen, who's
Lady
playing...
Lady Gaga.
Yes, Mel Gibson.
Sofia Vergara. Oh, my God.
Amber Heard.
Yes, Amber Heard. Michelle Rodriguez.
Damian Bichir. This is a Mexican actor who was was nominated for an Oscar this year.
But there's a few that we're not supposed to say because they're not...
They haven't been announced.
Released.
Yeah.
And there's some new people. Yeah, there are new people.
Thank you, stop it. Shit.
Anyway.
Gaga has been announced. How excited are you to be involved? I mean, this is her first film. This is...
Set when she arrived. We were freaking out. I mean, she is so... They had her so guarded. And I so wish, you know, that we could spend more time together. But she's just fucking awesome. Like, Lady Gaga is Lady Gaga, you know?
She's such a...
Badass.
Mission statement.
Yeah.
She's a concept. It's the weirdest thing. Like, just to know that we're in the same movie, it's epic. It's incredible. It's so weird and
we
extraterrestrial.
We just started screaming. We're like, oh my God. And Mel Gibson was like, why are you guys screaming? We're like, Lady Gaga's in this movie. He's like, oh. Like, oh, and you're too. You know, we're excited about
him. Great too, Mel. I mean, you mentioned Mel. I mean, you mentioned Mel. He's a legend in the action genre. What was he like on set? I mean, what's he like being there with him?
Yeah. But he's like he jumpy and fun, and he has a lot of stamina.
You see his age, and you know he's like, what, 50s? He's in his 50s. And he's sitting in a chair, and they're like, all right, it's, you know, Mel, you're next. And he gets on the stage, and he does his whole thing, and then he has to run in the scene, like, really hard, really fast. And he does
jump off the stage.
Jump off the stage in a second, like, nothing.
He jumps off the stage and jumps
don't
over
say,
this.
Don't say anything.
Okay. This, yeah. Anyway, and he, but there was, like, this AC unit.
And he just jumped
That was kind
over
of in the
it.
Middle. He wasn't supposed to be there. But, like, he would just jump over it.
Over
it,
and over
it. Every take. It was
so incredible, actually,
to see him.
He's in great shape, and he was extremely professional and loving and
very
just
sweet.
Brilliant actor.
Very sweet.
Yeah.
So to sum up, this is going to be the greatest sequel of all time. Mel Gibson has superpowers, and Lady Gaga is awesome. Yes. I think that's all good.
Yeah. I can't wait for you guys to watch Machete Kills. It's going to be freaking awesome. I think that you guys need to watch two other movies that I think you're going to like. There's a movie called Sushi Girl that's coming out next year worldwide, all over the world.
In theaters in January.
And Stripped. I just produced it, and you have to go see it.
And it's terrifying.
It's about organ doning.
Doning.
Not doning. Organ trafficking.
Yes.
Which is totally different.
Reluctant organ doning.
Yes. Reluctant. Strippedthemovie.com. It's awesome. I need to know what you guys think. Just go on the website, watch it, and tell me what you think.
Anyway.
Sushi Girl, can you just tell us very quickly a little bit about that?
Oh, my gosh. It's a revenge story, and it's... It's about a diamond robbery heist that happens a long time ago. And they come back to the present after this man who was convicted for the robbery comes out of jail. And he has to face everybody who all think he kept the diamonds. So it's pretty amazing. We have Mark Hamill, Noah Hathaway, who played Atreyu in, Atreyu.
Never ending story.
Yes, that's him. We have Tony Todd, Jeff Fahey, Michael Biehn, Danny Trejo, James Duvall. Just amazing. I'm really proud of this movie. Really proud of the whole, the crew, the director, Kern Saxton. He's amazing. And the producers. I just love it. I love this movie. And the girl. Oh, my God. She's so fucking great. I'm so sorry. I forgot her name. Because she's awesome. I need to tell you her name. Courtney Palm. Sorry, Courtney. Amazing.